Yo, what's going on, everybody? Hey, what's going on, everybody? There we go. I got the mic to work. What's going on, everybody, man? Thank you guys for tuning in to a early morning live stream here with me, Styles Streams, aka Kid, aka AG Styles. Today, guys, now that I got the reasonable stats, now that I think I can do this and I got more PVM under my belt, I'm gonna go ahead and try for my first ever fire cape. I know what you guys are thinking. What, you don't have a fire cape? What level are you? Man, I just want to say, yeah, I am behind, but I just want to say, RuneScape is the only MMO game that I've ever played my entire life. So, this is all like, in a way, it's new to me because the whole players prayer switching and all how that works, it's just new, and I'm adjusting to it. So. So what we're gonna do here, guys, is we're gonna watch I'm gonna watch a guide, and then I'm going to watch, and then I'm gonna gear while I watch a guide, look at the wikis and everything, and kind of keep you guys informed. And we're just gonna type in an OSRS JAD guide. Now we're gonna type in Joffstrife Hayes. This is one of the best guides I like for JAD, that is.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. I'm Josh Strife Hayes, and this is a complete beginner's guide to getting a fire
OSRS.
cape in old
Let's
school
just type in
RuneScape.
OSRS
This three-step
JAD
guide will explain
guide.
everything you'll need to
And
know
then we're gonna go to
about
the wiki,
conquering fight
guys.
caves and killing the Zoc Jad. If you're watching this video, you're probably thinking about attempting one of old school RuneScape's harder challenges, the fight caves. Or you've tried and failed several times. If you've been reading guides or watching videos, you've likely been bombarded by lots of different information. Complex tactics, weapon and armor swapping, prayer flicking, safe spotting. It can all
Range
be
only
very
that.
overwhelming. So, as with all of my guides, I'm going to break everything down into super simple steps. We'll go through the whole process of earning a fire cape in the simplest way possible. No complex armor or weapon swapping. No tick perfect prayer flicking, just simple, easy to follow steps. The fight caves are a seriously intimidating challenge. However, I believe the more you know about something, the less scary it becomes. So let's look at exactly what the fight caves are and how you can beat them. What are the fight caves?
Does it give me a
The
range bonus
Tsar
of 8?
City
I'll take
is the
that.
volcanic community within the Karamja volcano.
You get
There's
the
a
armor
bank,
plate,
some
armor
wandering
legs,
enemies, and a few minigames,
toxic,
including
blue
two
pipe,
of RuneScape's
and how much
hardest
is
player versus monster challenges, the ultra-high-level Inferno, and the mid-to-high-level Fight Caves. The objective of the Fight Caves is to fight your way through 63 waves of enemies, each wave increasing in difficulty, and then kill the final boss, the Zoc Jad. You can't rest or bank during this challenge. You have to do it completely solo, and getting to the final wave, the Jad, can take upwards of an hour. It's a test of skill, patience, and a little bit of luck. If you're able to survive these 63 waves and kill the Jad, you'll be rewarded with one of the best melee capes in the game, the Fire Cape. So we are here to kill the Jad. Our only objective is to reach wave 63, kill Jad, and get the cape. Now we know what we're doing, let's prepare. We'll need to look at what stats we'll need, what item and equipment we'll need to equip, the ideal inventory setup, and then the fight itself. Let's start with levels and stats. While it's possible to melee or mage your way through the fight caves, ranging has many advantages, so
what
that's the style we'll be using.
Bring?
Ranging
okay.
allows us to keep our distance from the melee enemies, picking them off one at a time, and reduces the amount we need to move around. We'll still have to wear some mid to high level armor to absorb a few hits, and praying protect from mage and protect from range is essential. Because of this, it's recommended to have 75 or more range, 70 or more defense, and a minimum of 40 prayer, although 60 is a good level to aim for. Magic isn't needed for the fight, and as we'll be praying protect from mage for most of it, magic level doesn't actually matter. If you don't have these stats, don't give up hope. It's absolutely possible to finish the fight caves at lower levels. It will, however, mean you'll be using lower level equipment and will have a much more difficult time. So once you've got close to these stats, it's time to gear up. Items and equipment. Once you're in the fight caves, you can't leave, so we need to bring some hard-hitting weapons and the best armor we can. I also don't want to be messing around with weapon or armor swaps during the fight itself. You're going to have enough to think about, so keeping it super simple will make you much more likely to succeed. I also don't want to break the bank. Not everyone has spare billions, so we'll be equipping ourselves as efficiently as possible. You don't need to be ultra rich to get the fire cape. Let's look at the weapons first. At 75 range, you'll be able to use the blowpipe. This weapon is brilliant. It's fast enough and powerful enough to absolutely shred through the weak enemies of the early waves, and then easily good enough to make relatively short work of Jad himself. The blowpipe needs two different types of ammunition. Zul'rah scales, which are used up at a rate of 2 scales every 3 shots, and then the actual darts it fires. You can load the blowpipe with any darts you can afford, up to Dragon. For this attempt, I'm going to recommend you use either Adamant or Rune, whichever you can afford. You'll need a few hundred of both darts and scales. Then use the darts and scales on the blowpipe and equip it, and you'll be good to go. No complex weapon swapping needed here. If you can't afford a blowpipe and ammunition, then Carol's crossbow and bolt racks, a rune crossbow with broad bolts, or even a magic shortbow with rune arrows will work. You'll just have a tougher time at the later waves. With your weapons sorted, let's look at filling in the other equipment slots. For your head, I'd advise a Verax helm, or a Blessed God coif. While an armadil helmet is the best, it's also expensive, and we're focused on keeping it simple and affordable. The Verax helm will provide great defense with only a minor ranged accuracy penalty. The God coifs are cheaper and have better accuracy, but much lower defense. I used a Verax helm. For your neck, a Fury or Glory will work fine. On your back, ideally, you'll want one of Ava's items, the Attractor, Accumulator, or Assembler, for the ranging bonus. If you've not got any of those, buy a God Cloak for the prayer bonus. For your body and legs, you have a choice of 3 main sets: God-Blessed Dragonhide, Carrels, or Verax. The God-Blessed Dragonhides offer ranged accuracy bonuses and small prayer bonuses and mediocre defense, while the Barrow's Armor have higher defense, but also cost more. Personally, I'd recommend a Verax Skirt for the heavy defense bonus and a God-Blessed Top for the ranged accuracy bonus, although you can mix and match here. If you're using a one-handed ranging weapon like a crossbow, you'll be able to equip either an Unholy Book, a Book of Law, or a Blessed Spirit Shield, although these aren't cheap items. If you absolutely cannot get hold of a blowpipe or a Carol's crossbow, and you have to use a rune or dragon crossbow, then a basic spirit shield is better than nothing. For gloves, the highest gloves you've unlocked from the Recipe for Disaster quest. If you've not done that quest, then God-Blessed Vambraces are also fine. For boots, Blessed God Dragonhide boots or snakeskin. And for your ring, the Archer's Imbued ring from the Nightmare Zone is best. If you don't have that, the Explorer's Ring from the Lumbridge Diary will give you a small prayer boost. With your weapons and armor set, we now need to look into what you're going to take with you, your inventory. With 28 limited spaces, everything needs a purpose. We're going to need to boost our ranging and defense stat, restore our health, and restore our prayer. With that in mind, here's what we'll need. Sarodome and Brews, Super Restores, and Bastion Potions. Let's go through why. The Sarodomen Brew is a great healing item with an annoying downside. A Sarah Brew contains 4 sips. Each sip restoring a certain amount of health based on your hit point level. At 60 hit points, it will restore 11 points per sip. That's 44 hit points per inventory space, which is amazing. However, each sip of Sarah Brew lowers your strength, attack, magic, and range, which is not so amazing. Thankfully, you can combine the Saradomin Brew with a Super Restore Potion. Each sip of Super Restore will restore any drained stats, including Prayer. However, it won't restore hit points. These two potions can be combined in a 3-to-1 ratio. If you take 3 sips of a Saradomin Brew first, then 1 sip of Super Restore, you'll restore a large amount of hit points and prayer, and your stats will be where they should be. If you're used to just eating food, you'll need to remember, taking 1 sip of a Saradomin Brew is not a good idea. It's best to wait until you need to take 3 sips in one go and combine it with a sip of Super Restore to make your supplies last as long as possible. I took 10 Saradomin Brews and 16 Super Restores. This is an expensive choice, but also provides the best healing and prayer restore you can have in the fight caves. A cheaper option is to swap out a few Super Restores for basic prayer potions. You'll save a few thousand, but remember, you won't be able to counteract the stat-draining Saradomin Brew with normal prayer potions. That leaves us with a few inventory spaces, which we'll be filling with Bastion potions and a stamina pot. A Bastion potion is essentially a ranging and defense potion combined, boosting your range and defense substantially. A stamina potion will allow us to restore our run energy quickly if we need to escape an ambush. Now we've geared up and have a full inventory of stat boosting, health filling, prayer restoring potions. We are as ready as we can be. You're about to start the fight case, so let's take this time to examine the arena you'll be fighting in and the enemies you'll face, and then discuss a few tactics for each one. However, that involves a lot of running around.
Contact, elbow pump. Very nice, Andrew. Very nice. Next, apparently.
All right, guys. I think we got most of our gear here, so I'll give you guys a quick little rundown. I'm gonna show you guys my screenshot folder.
Thank you.
Took a quick picture and show you guys what's up.
No $200 cleaning fees.
Microfiber, that chaps my hands.
You know, we should go over there right now and show them how fees are done.
Never pay a dealer fee with Carvana.
All right, so what we're going to do here, guys, is I'm going to add a image.
If you're running out of potions. In terms of gear, you want to bring your best range gear and weapons. I assume not everybody
desktop,
has nearly maxed gear, but you don't
equipment.
Need it. Similar to your
boom.
Stats, all right,
guys.
It easier and faster.
Hopefully you guys
can
see this
you
right here. You guys see this on
glory,
screen now.
Boots,
here is all of my gear and my gear set up. And all of my, weapons, too. All right, guys, so here, I'll go ahead and explain this real quick. Basically, what you're looking at is basically a rundown of my gear and my inventory. So, boom, bada bing, let's see here. We have a 0% mage strength bonus, a 18-plus strength attack bonus, a 127 range attack bonus with the dragon crossbow and the buckler equipped, plus 7 prayer bonus, plus a 37 weight. And now we have a negative 8 stab and a plus 164 defense, negative 9 in attack, plus 150 in defense, negative 8 in crush, plus 150 or plus 173. Wait. How is that reading it? How is that? Let's see here. Okay, yeah, there we go. Okay, attack bonuses. Those are okay. Attack bonuses, cool. We have a 220 range attack bonus with a 209 defense. With our blowpipe, we have a 186. I'll take another screenshot and get this out to you guys, so you guys don't want the blowpipe. Bring it out here. Going to add image, cool, browse, desktop, boom, bada bing, there's that, boom, two, open, apply, cool, a-okay, let's go. Alright guys, here goes our image number two with the blowpipe, and our range attack bonus is 186. Your defense bonus is 186 with a 151 attack. So, we're doing pretty good there, man. We're doing really good, guys. And let's go ahead and get this shit going. Let's go. Let's keep it going. Still watching the videos, you guys can see. Watching another one real quick.
Very powerful but low defense, so if you make mistakes, they could be very costly in Void. If you're doing this on a Slayer task, Void is out of the question since you want to wear your imbued Slayer helm or black mask. Make sure it's imbued though, as it is worthless for range if it is not. As for a weapon, you definitely want to bring a blowpipe if you have it, since it will drastically decrease how long this could take. Of course, not everybody has a blowpipe, so you could just use a rune crossbow and broad bolts for the whole thing. It would work. It's just going to be very slow at that point, and Jad could be a little tough. Although I do bring a blowpipe, I like to fight Jad with my armor crossbow just for the longer range. You could go as low as a crystal bow switch for this, but killing Jad with a blowpipe is still very doable. Make sure you bring some ruby or diamond bolts if you are using a crossbow on Jad. Could be regular or dragon, both work fine. For my inventory, I do bring a crossbow switch for Jad. You can use a rune crossbow if you don't have a dragon or an armor crossbow. If you're using a crystal bow, that's a solid option too, and you can kill Jad with a blowpipe. You just have less space to work with on the healers. If you have a twisted bow, bring that with dragon arrows. You're gonna breeze through Jad, no problem. I take 3 ranging potions so I can sip a little extra just to speed up the caves. If you're finding that you run out of restores or brews, you could replace ranging potions. My first trips, I would bring about 10 brews. Now I only tend to bring 5 with me. The more comfortable you get, the less damage you're going to take in the caves. But if it's your first time, I would bring 8 to 10 brews and then go from there. If you're using a blowpipe, you also have the spec to heal. Keep that in mind. I have a stamina in the bottom of my inventory. I don't use it that often. It's in case I'm running too much. I just have it with me. And then I fill the rest with super restores. If you still have any questions on gear or inventory at this point, please let me know. I'd be happy to answer you in the comments section as soon as I can. The fight caves are located in the Tsar City, which is located in the Karamja Volcano. I commonly use a glory teleport to Karamja and walk there, but there's also a minigame teleport to the fight pits, which is right next to the fight caves. As I'm about to discuss the actual fight cave fight, I think this is a good time to mention that I will be leaving a link to another video that I'm releasing with this guide, which will be an entire fight cave run that I do unedited, just so if there's anything in this video that you were hoping to get an answer for that you didn't, or just in general you want to see some specific examples, I've got a full run there for you to watch anything you need to see. I'm going to go over the different monsters you'll fight in the cave before you get to Jad. The fight caves are linear, so you'll always know what's going to spawn, but not necessarily where in the room it will. The first monster is a bat. The bat only has 10 health, it's very weak, but whenever it attacks you, even if it hits a 0, it drains some prayer points, which is really a pain, so this is high priority to kill these quickly. They could drain your prayer points a lot, but they are easy to kill. Next we have the muck. These use melee attacks and they only have 20 health. They also have this recoil effect. When you attack them, they'll do a little damage back, but you can't do anything about it. When you kill a muck, it'll spawn 2 mini mucks, which each have 10 health. Use melee if you're in his range, so don't step
before I do an I get the majority fight, part of it, okay guys, I just don't get the Jad pro switch, so styles,
but we'll only attempt to use melee if you're in his range, so don't step close. We got melee done. Each attack has a different animation, and you have a little bit of time, just a little bit, between the animation and the attack to switch on your correct prayer. You could also use the game sounds to do this. I just find that the range attack sound is a little late, and you just don't get that much reaction time, making it a little more complicated. Here's a look at his range and his mage attacks. His mage attack, he just drifts back while his arms stay pointing at the ground. While his range attack, he just flails his arm up and smashes the ground, dropping a boulder on you. You don't have a ton of time to react, but plenty of time as long as you don't panic. If you're trying to pot up or hit some meliors, which I'll discuss in a sec, just always make sure you're keeping your eyes on Jad. At the very beginning of the fight, it might seem easy because you're getting all the flicks right. It'll get a little bit hectic later on, you just gotta make sure you're watching Jad. Switching the prayers is pretty easy, but it only takes one mess up to get you killed very quickly, which is demotivating. Let's just watch a few Jad attacks in a row to get the feel of protecting from him. I'll go ahead and announce each attack that I see, but anybody who isn't an audio learner, you may mute if you wish. This is range attack, lifted his arms. Range attack again. His mage. Mage. So they look kind of similar at first. I'm mostly watching the arms. Mage. Arms are pointing towards the ground. It's got to be a mage attack. Arms went up. It's a range attack. Overall, you'll end up getting used to it when you practice a little. Alright, so now you're in the Jad fight and you get him down to half health. He's going to spawn some healers. These are just mini meliors that you saw from the last few waves. With decent defense, you can just attack each healer so that they attack you instead of healing him and tank their damage. They have the same mechanics as the big healers, so once they're aggressive, they can only use their healing attack if they're within range of hitting you, and they can only heal Jad if he's close enough to the healer. So you just gotta attack each one of them. You can let them attack you, or you can line them up so only one can attack you if you don't want to take that much damage, and then you can just attack Jad from far away. I sometimes use the blowpipe just to
Alright guys, let's do this. Installing a wave pit thing, it's gonna tell me what's next, what to expect, etc., etc. Damn, I forgot bat. Oh, wait, no, I did. I got ranges. Now the reason why you guys see me do that real quick and use this fat fuck to keep the bat away is because the bat will drain my prayer relatively quick. I am not looking at my stream chat right now, everybody. Let me get to that. Alright, there we go. I'm looking at it now, guys. So if everybody's want to say hi, any viewers want to tune in and give some advice, let me know. I am right here. I also, guys, have my Blood Fury. Oh, I don't have my Blood Fury. I should have blown my Blood Fury, man. Could have been getting some easy kills. You know what? I'm going to go get my Blood Fury because I'm getting my Blood Fury. Since I'm bringing my Sarah SGS, I now have a way to get my Blood Fury and use it. So, let's do that. Sorry, guys. Only a couple waves in. Nothing. Nothing to get all upset about. Blood Fury. Let's check it. Woo! 3k more hits. Alright, so let's go ahead and get out Sarah and Restore. And I want to bring out Bastion Potions instead. All right, now let's go. There we go, better names. Really want to save my angler for the last part. Let's see, guys. Look at my armor, man. My armor here is really playing a really playing a really big factor, because if you guys notice, usually you're needing that prayer right now for those Ranger guys, but I don't know, I'm testing the waters and I'm seeing how much I can take and handle, and seeing if I can't okay, looks like we might need it. Let's go ahead and take out our SGS, try and get some hits in maybe. There we go, nice little heal up there. Now let's test it. I did not even have a Bastion Potion drink, so shit, my range and defense was lower than fuck. Now I might not need it for these Rangers. Come when the Majors come, I will definitely need it, so. You ain't got no hoes. You ain't got no hoes. Where you at though? Look, you ain't got shit on me. Safe spot in your west. Trying to stay free. Trying to get a fire cape for the first time. So I can fucking flex on the dime. Show them who's boss. Show them I'm the man. Then I'll come home by him like Peter Pan. I got riches and I got bitches. No, I'm just playing. I be buying RuneScape GFs. Woo-hoo. Yeah, man, I'm about to become like the next Busta Rhymes, man, and be in the next Busta Rhymes fucking video, you know what I'm saying? Here, 1 second, guys. Had to lock my front door. We are good to go. I'm back. Ugh. Fuck out of here, bat. Sorry about that, guys. I was letting my clan know that I'm live streaming right now. Let's go ahead and try to get it. Oh, I don't need no wax. I'm good. I'm doing really good now, man. Now that my levels are higher, like, man, the last time I attempted this, guys, I'm telling you, I was really only, like, 70s, 80s, and my highest was range, and I had, like, 90 at that. So, me, like, really having some good defense now, man, my defense was 70 when I was doing this, bro. Like, oh my god, now I have 90, and I have good armor, I have some money to spend on some good weapons. I'm actually doing pretty good, man. I'm not even using prayer right now. I haven't even touched the Sarah Brew. I haven't touched anything. I can't find my phone charger, man. Oh, there it is, guys. My bad. I need my phone charger. Okay, there we go. I'm back. Okay, before any damage has been done. Cool. Alright, might fuck my prayer up there a little bit. I think these two prayers would be more than enough to get me through the beginning levels of this, beginning part of this, whatnot. Ranger, okay. So anything melee, I'm gonna try to use up close. Or anything that's, like, blobs, bad, something that gets up close, I'm gonna try to use melee on them. Thank you. Oh, I just emptied one of my fucking Sarah Brute. No! What time does Mage come? I think that's like 30. Man, I did not mean to drink that. Thank you. mage. Here we go, guys. Now, so from this point forward, guys, we have to keep our mage on at all times. I'm not going to take risks. No more chance taken. Let's get it going. Let's get this shit going. Wave 30 is the real deal, boys. Now, wave 32, we have a bat and a mage. Where's the bat? Next wave is two bats and one mage. Mage is probably back here somewhere. Before you guys freak out, there is a reason behind that. What the fuck? I have mage on, yo. Thank you. All right, so I went for it, guys, and I go ahead. I went for the reheal.